It's time now for the next after-the-fact mystery. Tonight, a mountain of evidence.
Will you please slow down? I'm not a mountain goat, just in case you hadn't noticed.
No, I'd never take you for a goat of any kind. Let's see, though, if you were an animal, what would you be?
Right now, I'd like to be a slug, very close to the ground, just trailing my way along very safely.
But you are very close to the ground. At the moment, it just happens to be vertical, that's all.
Oh, don't remind me. I can't believe I ever let you talk me into this in the first place.
Ah, but think of all the hardy mountain men who come up here every day looking for precious stones so that you and I can live better lives if we happen to be in dire need of amethysts.
Well, they're sure trying hard to get them. Looks like they've blown up half the mountain.
Not those two. What are their names?
Slattery and Rideau. When did you say they took over the mine?
3 months ago.
Just 3 months together, and one of them pushes the other one off the cliff?
A little falling out.
Aren't you ever serious?
Gosh, going down is a lot easier, isn't it?
Oh, easy is not the word I would use. Can we just stop here on this handy-dandy ledge for a minute? I'm dying.
Oh, we're practically there.
Oh, if you don't mind, I think this outcropping and I have just bonded. I feel very emotionally attached.
Places to go. Things to do.
Oh, look. Just stay right there. Just for a blink or two.
I don't think Mr. Rideau is going to stay on his ledge forever.
He's dead, Mark. He's not in any hurry.
But I suspect that Slattery is. Now, if he can tumble that body another 1,000 feet before we get back with the mountain patrol, he'll probably be able to put one over on all of us. Now, there has to be some way of bagging that guy, something that's going to trip him up.
If they really argued like he said they did, and Rideau tried to kill him the way he said he did, and if Rideau really fell off the cliff during an altercation...
An altercation? You mean a fight? What did Rideau do? Hit Slattery with a thesaurus?
No. As a matter of fact, he tried to blow him up.
Blow him up?
That's right. With dynamite. That's how they've been opening up the mountaintop. With dynamite.
Well, sure.
Slattery was burning off some stumps, and Rideau pitched a stick of dynamite right into the fire. Slattery was lucky enough to throw himself behind a rock before it blew. We saw the hole.
Oh, we sure did.
And then, after the explosion, Slattery was so mad that he rushed Rideau right at the cliff's edge, and they had at it.
And just by chance, Rideau was the one who went over, 75 feet down.
And it was just the two of them. Just one now. There's nothing to prove. Hey, where are you going? My minute's not up yet.
I don't count on that. Let's get a move on. But I won't be surprised if our Mr. Slattery isn't there when we come back with the mountain patrol. I think he's the one who's gone over the edge. Some wheelchair. I wish somebody would oil this thing. $20 a day and it sounds like a bent shopping cart.
You heard what the man said, Mark. It's been a busy day on the mountain. So many climbers getting owies.
Well, it wasn't my fault. I could swear that rock wasn't there on the way up.
Oh, no. It was probably just an oversight. After all, you were very preoccupied, just like Slattery. He was tripped up by a little oversight, too.
The only good thing about this entire day.
Who knows? He may end up in the same hospital bed you had, the one watched over by the pretty nurse.
Unless he breaks his neck instead of his foot. Well, they said he was in a real hurry to get away.
Well, he sure tripped himself up, lying. Imagine that.
Oh, horrors.
It's still hard to believe.
What?
Well, that if you throw dynamite into the fire, it doesn't blow up.
Well, it doesn't. Take my word for it. No fuse, no explosion.
Your fuse seems a little short today.
Will you please slow down? I think I'm about to lose a wheel.
Be sure to listen for the next After the Fact Mystery.